Nom nom.
Thank you so much, and welcome to Sunday with Ola number 23. I'm still working a little bit with the vlog. Did you see the last Sunday with Ola? I was, you know, playing around or toying around with a new mode I'm filming. What's up over there? So I'm still kind of getting that together and see if I can, you know, make it work. I'm learning, guys. I'm learning. But what's important is that you guys are here today to watch Sunday with Ola. This Sunday with Ola will be filled with amazing content. Like me putting a dick in my mouth. That's kind of like the lowest point I've ever had in any of my videos. But I'm doing it for you guys, okay? For you guys, I will put a dick in my mouth at all times, just saying. Okay, let's just head over to the news. So this past week has obviously been dominated by the passing of Eddie Van Halen, and rightfully so. But I did actually find newsworthy news. And the absolute best news of this past week is that Pliny released a new single. And ladies and gentlemen, Pliny is instrumental music at its finest, in my opinion. I just love this guy. He's incredible. Incredibly talented, and I don't know where he gets all those beautiful melodies from, and, you know, just song ideas. He's an excellent songwriter, and it's the absolute best traveling music. You know, when I'm out touring or just out traveling in general, number one thing that I listen to is Pliny, because it really fits the traveling aspect of traveling. Holy shit, my English today is on the point. On the point, not on point. On the point. No, but Pliny's music is basically the perfect companion for traveling or riding a car or whatever. It's just like so soothing. It's music that makes you happy, and empowering music. And, you know, that's what it's all about. Empowering ourselves in these difficult times. And I think this new Pliny single is absolutely on the money. And, you know, because this is a show talking about me and myself at all times, you know, I also have to say again regarding Pliny and him going to the Haunted show when we were playing in Sydney, like 2014 or 15 or something like that. And he was in the pit, moshing along, and I met him afterwards. He was sweaty as hell. What a champion right there, just saying. I just think that Pliny is way too underrated. He's one of the modern geniuses when it comes to guitar and music, in my opinion. He's incredible. And I urge you, if you haven't, to go check out this single and also his previous stuff, because it is amazing, and I'm telling you so, okay? You know, as we lost a legend last week, you know, I've been thinking a little bit more about other legends that have passed way too soon. Somehow I got into Chris Cornell on YouTube. So I was browsing YouTube, as, you know, any normal person in my age at this time. And I stumbled onto this video from Guitar Center. It's basically Soundgarden at the Guitar Center, Seattle, Washington. And if you're a Soundgarden fan or like a, you know, a grunge fan in general, it's a really, really good video to watch. And it also made me realize how much I miss Chris Cornell. And this is not to, you know, pull any shade on Eddie Van Halen. Eddie Van Halen's passing was a tragedy as well. I just ventured on to this mourning thing and I eventually ended up in this video. And watching this today, watching this with Chris Cornell in the Guitar Center video here talking and all that, it made me genuinely happy. And watching this video, I was thinking, perhaps we're taking our heroes for granted. You know, the heroes that are still alive and among us. I think we should celebrate that more. I mean, celebrate our heroes that are still out there grinding it, working hard. And I was just thinking about this when I was listening to the new Pliny song that I was talking about before. It's just that we're so lucky, we're so spoiled with all these amazing talents and musicians that are out there. And we should all celebrate them a lot more, in my opinion. I don't know. That was just a little side note right there. And when I was seeing this video, you know, I kind of derailed into something else, and that is that I found a lot of videos about how it is to actually work at a Guitar Center or a guitar store in general. So I figured I would show you a couple of videos that I really, really appreciate now. Let's check out this. What it's really like to work in a music store. This guy is so happy right now. Look at his face. He finally got his job, his dream job. I mean, back in the day, I was really thinking like, wow, wouldn't it be amazing to work in a guitar store? When I'm watching this, I'm thinking maybe not so much. That was the same guy. Okay, I think these guys are our true heroes right there. The people working in a music store that has to endure all of this. It's amazing. And here's another one from Guitar Center Times Square. Wow, this guy's rocking out. Shit. Hell, man. This is absolute hell. Hell on earth. But this guy's really kicking it right there. Oh shit, he's rocking. This guy right here, he's having a f***ing show at this point. Look at this guy. He's performing in front of these guys. That drumming is amazing. I've never experienced this. I mean, I've been to guitar stores in Sweden. This doesn't happen here. I don't know why, but it's not that they're playing as bad. It's just that everyone's playing at the same time and trying to kind of... Everybody's kind of competing about volume, I guess. But still this guy. Dude, I'm a fan. Who is this guy? We have the overly annoyed girlfriend waiting for his husband to finish off his 8-string playing. She's not impressed. She's definitely not impressed with the 8-string. And that's why I keep telling everyone, you don't need an 8-string. 6-string is okay. You will still get whamming, okay? I think the takeaway of this video is that this guy is killing it in front of his audience right here. And they're so impressed by his playing. And he's like, yeah, there you go. I don't know why that happened. I just stumbled upon these videos and I thought they were hilarious. So there you go. How it is to work at a Guitar Center. Lovely.
Alright, so me and Luis are walking here in the woods. Well, it's not exactly woods, but we're walking here. And where are we going?
We're going to the goats.
We're going to go check out some goats. Luis is actually a part of like a goat community.
Yep, I'm actually a caretaker.
That's so what we need.
I take care of them once a week.
Once a week?
Yeah.
She takes care of the goats. And I'm going to honor them with my presence today. And let's just see what happens. Go inside. Hello, little goatees.
Hey, Carlo, how are you?
Hey, Borde.
Kolla hans ögon. Vart är det här?
This is the biggest goat of them all. This is the leader. It's Odin, obviously. You don't want to mess with him.
Yeah, but he wants to cuddle. He loves to cuddle.
Look at those horns, man. Insane.
Oh, my meat.
Are you waiting for some hugs?
Oh, this is the hugger. She wants to hug you.
She wants to hug? Oh, that's cute. Oh, hello. Hey. Wow. They really remind me about dogs and their behavior, in a way, right? They're like equally cuddly. And it's funny because they always smile too. Look at that. Are you happy? Are you happy? That's a good scratch right there. What are you doing? Is this the old one?
Yes. Trying to get up.
Oh, are you okay? Do you need help? So one of the things that needs to happen is that Luis needs to count all the goats. Make sure all of them are here. They're all here?
Yep.
Awesome. I mean, these goats have the most awesome view. Look at this. Look at this. It's beautiful. Hello, old goatee. I think this is the oldest goat they have. Oh, she's taking shit right in front of my camera. Great. They're very calm right now.
Yeah.
What? Hello. Hello. You want cuddles? Oh, we have the same type of beard, you and I. Oh, was that nice? Yeah, I like that too. When Louise strokes my beard. It's good. Feels good. Have you eaten breakfast? Is that good? Is it good? So one of the tasks usually when Luis is here is to bring the goats out, and then it could be complete chaos. You bring them out of here and there's the fields just right next to this, and sometimes it's a little hard to herd them all. But if Odin, the big asshole, is there, then he leads the way. Right, Odin? Well, this guy, your horns are insane. Just saying. What? I mean, how many years is this? What? It's very soothing.
Right? That's why I come here.
Just become one with the goats.
Yeah.
Look at this, okay? There you go. Oh, oof. Crotch. Right in the crotch. Oh, he wants more. Oh, shit. He's actually pushing. Oh, up. He's pushing it. What are you doing, man? Oh, he's getting pissed. He wants more. I've been too good to him. Look at his tail, man. What are you doing? Calm down. I feel you're getting a little bit needy right now. You know, you have to let me pet the other goats. Just saying.
I feel it's getting a little bit hostile. Look at this guy. Look.
Oh, that's cute. Oh my goodness. They're so cuddly and nice. Look at this. Do you want to go home with us?
Yeah, I'm gonna buy this one.
Look at this guy. He knows how to party. Look at that. That seems so comfortable right there. This is the singer of Immortal right here. Look at that. Hello. Oh, someone's hugging my ass. Who's that? Oh, that's you. You know, for being used for pentagrams and stuff, these are not really that
not dangerous. That evil.
No, that's not that evil. These are the exact opposite of evil. See you, goats. It's been a pleasure. Bye, guys. See ya. That was fun. I think we can learn a thing or two from the goats.
Yeah.
At least the people on social media. They can probably learn a thing or two. You know, just stay calm and nice.
And cuddle
a lot. And hugs, man. Solves basically almost all the problems in the world, I think. All right, that's Adventures with Ola for you right there. See ya.
So for every Sunday with Ola, I have these riff challenges happening every single week. So that song that you heard in the beginning there, that is an original thing that I wrote for this Sunday with Ola. I'm trying to challenge myself every week to write something. And the Sunday with Ola Riff Challenge is all about that. Just pushing yourself to write something to try and be creative. Every week, at the end of the year, you have 52 riffs, songs, whatever. It's just me trying to force music out of me when I'm in a rut, basically. If you're in a rut and you feel like, you know, you can't do shit on guitar, this is a really good way to just force that shit out of there. And, you know, sometimes it's good, sometimes it's not as good. And that's not the point. The point is just to get that shit out of there, get that out of your system, write some bullshit. And the drums from this week's intro is available for you to download in the description of this video. Last week I had Unchained Van Halen, and we're gonna check out some of you guys' submissions for this week. So let's go. This is Void, Boris. Yes. And he's using a HM2 or something similar. It's the Swedish death metal chainsaw tone, at least. I can tell immediately that this guy is a really, really cool dude. And you know why? Because he has sunglasses on his head inside. Just a little side note. This is sludgy, man. I like this. Sick as fuck! That's Void Boris right there. So here we go, Red Waters. Red Waters, everyone. I like the pants. Nice, man! He has Budweiser pants on. That's a plus point in my book, I like that. Gibson Les Paul studio, that's cool. Sounds chunky. Are you using the spider back there? I don't know. Nice, I like these melodies, man. There you go, Red Waters for you right there. And here we have Eugene Rowe with a sick ass Solar. That's an Artist AB 1.7. He has a casting couch back there. It's funny when you hear someone else play a solar guitar. You can still hear the elements of when I'm playing a solar guitar. Makes sense. You know, it's the same pickup and all. The same. Yeah, baby! Do we have time for one more? Yes! We do. Who's this? Nicola Lodolo. Ooh. Yeah, man, this is cool. This is more in the vein of Van Halen. There we are. That's it right there. Nicola Lodolo, well done. If you want to be just as cool as these cats right here, do the riff challenge. Download the drums in the description, upload it to YouTube, and you might get featured in the next Sunday with Ola.
Ola Tasting Shit.
What's up, everyone? Welcome to Ola Tasting Shit. We have one last piece of Metal Raven, My Beautiful Little Members package. I think it's going to be humiliating for both of us. You can open it. And it will most definitely go in the thumbnail, just saying. What does it say, Louise?
Do I have to?
Mm-hmm.
Candy, low job, practice Willy. I think you're gonna practice. Mm-hmm.
It says on the box, practice makes perfect. But this is gonna be a problem, because now everyone's gonna make memes out of me, you know, eating this. Oh my god. Like this?
The problem is, I'm probably gonna like the taste of that. Because I like jelly food. Or jelly
mm-hmm.
stuff.
You don't remember when we ate a dick?
Yeah.
It's probably gonna be the same. Oh my goodness. I like how the balls are really scrunchy and, you know,
yeah.
Wrinkly.
I just really hope this is not like a self-mold thing. And this is Mel
this
Raven.
Is someone's...
I just want to make sure before I lick this thing.
It was in plastic.
I think I have to censor this because I don't want people to use this against me.
Yeah. Maybe you should just turn around.
It's actually really good. you're not gonna look at me in the same way.
It's okay.
Okay. I'm done.
Smells. It smells so nice.
Like the real deal.
Not
so much. There's some competition now in this family. Damn.
That's pretty nice.
It is pretty nice, thank you. You want to try for it?
Okay.
Okay.
It's a strawberry.
It's
no, but I can't, I don't want to suck it because... Oh, let's just do it.
I thought it was going to be softer, but it's really hard.
It's rock hard. Yeah.
Really hard.
All right, good. Are we going to finish this off?
It's just
or?
Put them together next.
Let's just demonstrate how hard it is. It is really hard. Okay, there it is. I sucked the dick. I ate a dick before, now I suck the dick on camera.
I think it was
and it's
tasty.
There's a lot of veins and shit on it as well. It's just very, very realistic, I must say. So somebody has probably made a mold of this.
Yeah.
And whoever you are out there, congratulations. Thank you. And now it's, this challenge has just entered a new low. And I'm
Thanks
sorry
to
for that.
Friend.
I'm sorry. Thank you, Mel Raven. Hola tasting dick.
And that, my friends, was the end of this Sunday with Ola right here. Thank you so much for watching this Sunday with Ola. I hope you had a good time and hopefully we'll see each other soon. You can like, you can subscribe, you can push that notification bell, you can become a member even and be awesome, you know, just saying. But I'm gonna go have a great Sunday with myself right now. Not masturbating, I'm just gonna go with my family and do something, okay? Shit. Okay, bye.